colleagues. Mr. President, you may wish to recall that the Senate at its sitting on Tuesday, the 18th April 2016, referred the above bill to the committee for further legislative input. Consequently, the committee held a public hearing on Tuesday, the 17th May 2016, to get public and stakeholders' input. Therefore, the committee went on a facility visit to the campus of the university in Efo Delta State on the 20th to the 21st May 2016. The university was established since March 2007 to meet the yearning of the Nigerian state and the immediate community in training professional engineers and scientists with the technical know-how to drive the petroleum industry. You may wish to know that the university is fully operational, but without enabling law. Also, it is the first of its kind in Africa and sixth in the world. The status that makes it a highly demanding institution in the provision of technological education in Nigeria and Africa. The contribution of the public and stakeholders assisted the committee in arriving at the following positions. The bill, as in the introduction, an act to provide for the establishment of the Federal University of Petroleum Resources, Infuru, and other related matters 2016, SB 226, is an executive bill seeking to give legal backing to the Federal University of Petroleum Resources, Infuru, Delta State. We have about 16 membership in the committee. The committee's consideration of the report and 2.1, the methodology. The committee made a close-by-close analysis of the provision in comparison with the provision of other acts establishing existing university, especially as it affects specialized institutions. You may wish to know that the university is already operational without enabling law, though the bill was passed in the 7th Senate, but it was not assented to. It is expedient, therefore, to pass this bill in order to give the university legal foundation. The findings. The committee notes that the structure of the bill was in line with the law establishing other university. However, in order to expand the academic coverage and funding channels of the institutions, the committee made the following recommendation. 3.0 committee recommendation. The committee recommends that section 1 to section 26 should be retained as in the bill, except for section 1 subsection 4 should be altered to read thus: the university shall be supervised by the Ministry of Education with the following responsibilities. A. The Federal Ministry of University through the National University Commission shall be responsible for approving, regulating all academic programs run in the university to ensure quality compliance and provide funds for academic and research program infrastructures and remunerations of employees. B. The Federal Ministry of Petroleum Resources, Petroleum Technological, Technology Development Fund, the PTDF, and Nigerian Content Development and Monitoring Bill shall provide 2% of their annual budget for research program in petroleum technology acquisitions and research facility. Section 31A should be altered by inserting the phrase "and other areas at issue regard," to offer courses of instructions, training, and research in petroleum technologies and allied areas for the production of middle and high-level manpower and other skilled personnel required to run the oil and gas industry in Nigeria, in particular, and the world at large. Section 51A should be altered by removing the phrase chairman and replacing petroleum resources with education, and thus read, the pro-chancellor who shall be representative of the Honorable Minister of Education. Section 51E is altered by removing the phrase by the National Council of Ministers and will thus read, four persons representing a variety of interests and broadly represented of the following federation to be appointed for. Section 51E, Roman figure 3, should be altered to reach two other persons, one of whom shall be a representative of the university host community. Section 91H should be expunged so that section 1 will become the new H and J becomes I, and a new phrase is then inserted as J. Interest of investment, I donations and legacies accruing to the university from any source for the general or special purpose of the university. J, annually, Tech Fund shall give to the university a special project in oil and gas infrastructure in addition to regular normal intervention. Section 9.2 should be altered to read, the Federal Ministry of Petroleum Resources shall ensure that special funding is made available to the university on an annual basis as follows. The oil and gas companies operating in Nigeria shall also contribute 0.5% of gross profit to the academy and infrastructural development of the university. The Nigerian Content Development and Monitoring Board shall contribute at least 2% of its gross revenue for the research and development of materials, processes, equipment and system for local content realizations of the petroleum industry by the university. D. The Nigerian National Petroleum Corporation shall provide the equivalent of the annual personnel cost of the university as oil industry incentive allowances to staff of the university. Section 24 should be altered by inserting 24, subsection 10, which reads, subsection 10, all oil and allied companies working in Nigeria shall make their facility available for research purposes on demand. Section 3.1, subsection 5, is altered by insertion of the phrase and units to read heads of academic departments and units. In conclusion, the committee recommends that the Senate do approve the above recommendation. The passage of the bill into law will facilitate the provision of an enabling environment law for the university. The committee expresses profound gratitude to the entire Senate for the opportunity it has given to provide the legal backing of the university. That's all.